This is a curbside pickup. We're gonna come in, get these sucked up, haul them away. And while we're doing that, I'm gonna give this yard a real quick light blow up. And James is gonna get everything sucked up. So let's get to it. Oh, by the way, I'll do a leaf cleanup setup video, but we're using the 18 horsepower Billy Goat this year. Two Echo 8010s, 61 inch Ferris, 31 inch or 36 inch X Mark. And we've got a Little Wonder parking lot blower. So that's our leaf setup. Then we got the box and a one ton Ford. It's a 2004. We're gonna get to work. What's up? Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're just gonna be doing a curbside pickup, and I'm gonna talk about that a little bit, kind of our pricing and things like that. I want to go ahead and talk about this Billy Goat real fast. So it's something new. A lot of people have wondered what setup we're using this year. And without a leaf loader, doing curbside pickup for anybody would be pretty much impossible. So the benefits to having a leaf loader: you're not tarping it and dragging it into your trailer or into your truck bed. You're not having to use the mower to vacuum it up and condense it down. So when it gets sucked through the leaf loader, it reduces the size. Now, I wouldn't say that it really speeds up cleanup time on some of these small properties. You know, it's right in line with how quick tarps would be, but what it does allow me to do is have more capacity in my setup and more versatility. Like, if you look at my setup, you can tell I like to have the mowers and stuff with me. And the reason being is I use the mowers as a tool to avoid using rakes. Well, if you use rakes, you'd be skinnier. You'd have more access. Shut up. Unless you're doing the work, no, whatever. I use what's efficient, what's quick, what makes me money. And if you're in this industry, you know it's all about speed, all right? I bill everything on time, but I still want to get it done fast. So right here, what's going on is we're having some issues with... it's getting clogged up and slugged up, and we're trying to figure out why. Just doing a little troubleshooting. Is the hose not hooked up right? Is something going on? Was something not cleared through the line? So James was using it, and at this point I'm just kind of checking it to see, hey, am I seeing something? And it clogged up on me too. So it ended up being that there was a stick caught in the hose, and it was like caught sideways, and we couldn't see it. So we ended up getting it out, and then it started working better for us. But it took us a few times getting it slugged up to realize that that thin little stick was caught sideways. So, you know, one of those things, I was just seeing if it was user error. Sure enough, it got both of us, and it was. All that said, you're probably wanting to know about pricing. So for me on pricing, I charge everything by a man hour rate. That's up to you. I mean, if you're in the business, you can charge by a price per job and stuff like that. I'll just explain how that works real fast, okay? If you're confused by hearing it, I charge 1 hour. Say if we're at the property 1 hour with two people, that is 2 man hours, okay? 1 hour, one person, 1 man hour. Two people for an hour is 2 man hours. Three people for an hour is 3 man hours. So the number of people you have at the property is a multiplier, all right? That's all it is. You're charging a man hour rate times however many people I have at that property. For me, that is it's a security thing. I'm able to bid jobs over the phone. So when somebody calls me, I'm a busy dude during leaf season. It's high pace, it's fast. You can only fit so many jobs in during the day. I'm in a vehicle that costs a lot of money to drive around. It's a gas guzzling machine, and you're towing everything behind you. It takes up time. If I'm driving around and I got James in the truck or any other employee, then I'm looking at added labor. Anytime you go to talk to somebody and you're going through a process, giving them an estimate, there's time that you can lose because maybe they want to talk and ask questions and a bunch of stuff that could just be handled on the phone. But when you're in person, you might get caught into just a BS conversation about this and that or whatever, their dog and, you know, that kind of stuff, which is fine. I love building relationship with clients and having some rapport there so that they know, hey, I'm here to take care of you. But at the same time, when we're busy, we're busy. And because of our size and our skill and what we're trying to do, what's best for me is to be able to charge it over the phone. So you might ask how I do that, or not charge it over the phone, but estimate it over the phone. And like I said, that keeps me from driving all over town, Tulsa's got a pretty decent sized metro area, so I can easily get caught up for 2 or 3 hours a day driving around. The days are a lot shorter in the fall. So again, they call me up and I say, hey, how you doing? They ask about leaf removal. I talk to them. I let them know I bill out on a man hour rate. I'm straightforward with them and I tell them how much the man hour rate is. And then I just outline what they can expect as far as how quick I can be there and how the service works. And then we send them a card on file link. They put a card on file and then we're ready to go. So we got a couple clogs. We're still figuring it out. It's wet. We have a few issues. So yeah, I got my hose hanging flaccid, okay? Don't be judging me. But the hose, it kind of, I gotta have enough length in case I have the trailer anything but straight so that I can shoot it in to the box. Now I have this mount that's kind of catches the hose, and on the inside I think sticks and stuff are catching there, so it gets clogged here. And then on this hose, it's got ribs, and I don't know how smooth the inside is, but it seems like sticks are turning sideways and getting caught there, which happened with our cyclone rig, but it had a smaller diameter hose. But it pulled through easier. It was also a shorter length of hose and it didn't have as much flex to it. So the inside was incredibly smooth and it just fly through it. I think what I'm gonna do is take some of that hose and replace this black hose. And so it'll be loosely hanging on this, but it'll shoot straight into the truck and hopefully not have any of those hang up points. It's time to shed the hoodie, man. It got warm real fast. But hey, if you like these Juggernaut hoodies, man, they feel really good on the inside. They're kind of lightweight, so you know, I don't know about you, but during leaf season I'll wear a t-shirt sometimes because you get to move and you get hot. So like, it feels cool today, but again, we were moving and we got hot. These are nice and warm and they look cool. So if you want to join the Juggernaut militia, you can pick these up in the merch shelf underneath the video. Anyways, we're gonna go ahead and get to the next property and we're gonna show you that too, because today we're doing it a little different. Instead of showing you one property, we're gonna vlog it. Leaf log. And James is back from Kansas to come help out in good old Oklahoma. You always got to recruit the Kansas boys to work hard. All right, that's where we're originally from. We outwork everybody in Oklahoma. Anyway, oh, you want to see what's in the box, don't you? Okay, keep in mind it was wet, so we didn't get that good of a shred. This was completely empty because we went to the dump. And now, it's about a quarter to half full, which I'm not impressed with. I would like to see a lot better results than that, because with our cyclone rake, something like that, even though it was wet, would get a real, real, real fine shred. So yeah, let's go ahead and get to the next.